and I hope most of you do, push to talk is simply pressing down a button which triggers your microphone to open and you can speak into it. And once you let go of the button, your microphone then closes. This can be helpful if you have super sensitive microphones or if you live somewhere where there's a lot of background noise and you don't want all of that background noise actually going through the stream. That can kind of be really, really annoying. But that option is there, and 200 milliseconds isn't that bad. With these options here, you can either go 200 or minus 200. You really can't go any higher or lower than that, with the exception of maybe a third party audio program. And then right below that you have desktop boost. So what is the desktop boost? Well, look right above it. The first option we messed with was the desktop audio device, which is our headphones, right? So we have the gameplay, we have TeamSpeak, we have music, all going through my headphones, and they're all being transmitted to my stream. The desktop audio device? But when I watch my stream, it's not as loud. So
we have the gameplay, we have TeamSpeak, we have music, all going through my headphones, and they're all being transmitted to my stream. The
desktop but device, when I watch my stream, right? It's not so as loud.
So we have the gameplay, we have TeamSpeak, we have music, all going through my headphones, and they're all being transmitted.
Not so as loud.
So we have the gameplay, we have TeamSpeak, we have music, all going through my headphones, and they're all being transmitted.
Not as loud.
So we have the gameplay.
Yeah.
I'm so far out of sight. Yeah, that sounds about right. Sounds about right. That keep you.
judge. I'ma rock you like a baby. Turn you out, yeah, I'm that one. I'ma get you where I want you. I'm so far out of sight. Yeah, that sounds about right.
I just took some Miley with us. Got some bitch from Dallas with us. She gon' fuck your squad with us. I'ma fuck her bras with us. Bitch from Pakistan with us. Ferraris in them lambs with us. About to fuck this club up with us.
Metro Boomin' want some more, nigga.
I turn the Ritz into a pole house. It's like eviction number four now. Go ahead and that shit on the floor now. Girl, go ahead and show me how you go down. And I feel my whole body peeking. And I'm fucking anybody with their legs wide. Getting faded with some bitches from the west side. East coast, nigga, reppin' north side. Never waste a whole time. Bitch, I'm on my own time. Fuck a nigga, cosign. Always change my number.
As well, but now that they're finally shining, you know, Archie, he said it in the interview. So,
that's actually a really good one. I love that sign.
Nice hat.
So did I when I did that.
But I mean, I completely love my train of thought, but Archie said in an interview they play better versus better teams, and I think Virtus Pro, they bring out the best in EG, and that is really great to see.
From player perspective, is playing to the level of your opponent a real thing? Isn't that something that teams genuinely can trap that they can fall into?
Absolutely. Like, when you're playing versus a team that, like, you said, like, you don't really respect, you can try to just. You just kind of joke around sometimes. It's not. It can be very bad for your team because you're just like, oh, you know, we're better than these guys, and you just, yeah,
it's right. It's a bad attitude. It's a
bad attitude.
I love this stuff.
It's able to battle quite early on.
Damn it! I know it's not the deal, but you can sell through the tornado.
From both sides, so obviously Ramsey's with the Blood CK's head down towards the bottom lane, but also EG, they've moved Universe down here, and they're playing this Morana lane at the top aggressively. They're moving the lane so they want expected, really, out of this pairing, do you think?
More so, EG. VP wanted to have the... They want the Bloodseeker versus Kimbasaur, but they would have preferred it in the safe lane, with VP having a 2v1 kind of lane, with Ramsey can get help from the Doom. The Doom set up in his own jungle, which means if Ramsey's against the Kimbasaur up top, the Doom can swoop in and offer a gank threat, but out bottom, there's no real rotations that are that easy unless Lil Ops to like make a move all the way from his jungle, which he may have to pick up like a boost, a smoke, roam down bottom. It's an okay matchup for Bloodseeker because Uni's often going to be low HP, tanking the creep and getting down to like half HP, which gives Bloodseeker damage, but it's also a bad matchup because Uni's always going to have the HP regen with the reactive armor.
Absolutely, it's going to be very hard for Ramsey to do anything aggressive until he hits that level 6 and Universe will have to be just a little bit careful. He's staying in this mid lane as well. Zai continue to farm the jungle, get a few levels before he starts to make those movements, but the majority of pressure from VP putting on this mid lane as they have three heroes kind of circling around both Zai and Samael.
See what Lil's move is going to be. Zai is playing, yeah, very defensive behind his core, still showing up, but don't really see a... Oh, is there a kill here? With the Orb of Venom, it's close. Universe, only the 2 points in the reactive armor. Not quite level 5 just yet, but he's going to be more than okay.
And CSY 17 for 1 on Uni against Ramses 20 for 4, so fairly close down on that bottom lane.
That's easy.